coming to the height that you people have been asking questions for. How do we do it and how does it happen? That's the fundamental question. And I was rather shy. I thought these people are, honestly, I was very shy. I am supposed to be talking only hypnosis. I shouldn't show my medical knowledge. And I should keep away from philosophy. That was the paradigm I was working. Ul told me, Bhaskar, you are stupid. See, that's how we have made good friends. Because first thing we arrived was that the time is what we do not have. Everything else we have, there is a time constraint and we want to do so much of work. So let's be straight. So he says, you are stupid. You think we don't appreciate philosophy? So, all right, I talk philosophy for 5 minutes and then hand you over to Radhni to talk about those molecules and genes that you want to know and how hypnosis is connected to those molecules and genes. But beyond those molecules, beyond those genes, the consciousness, human consciousness, not talking of mind, something which since millennia we are trying to understand and we have not understood, what is human consciousness? Charles Darwin was wrong. Only 152 years or so to prove him wrong. Charles Darwin says there is an evolution of the species. Howsoever hard that we may try, let's not demolish Darwin, but believe me, he was wrong. Human intelligence, human, Radhni used the word intelligence, that is synonymous with consciousness of the human being, is something so pristine, so evidently there, and yet we don't understand. But there is communion in the consciousness. When we are tuned to the people, yesterday morning only, I demonstrated to you that the thoughts radiate themselves like the radio waves and are perceived for those who want to listen. Those who have switched off the radio, there is no music in this room. So, how does hypnosis work? And for that, those who want to write down me, because this is not written in any book of it. It's not on Google either. Simple three stages can last for a lifetime. my fault. Okay. I like playing. I'll read it for you all. I have used the word thought. The first line is creative power of thought. Now, the word thought I have used because there is no better word. But the word here means thought, wish, desire, intense craving, yearning, from the bottom of my being. Are you with me? It's not like wanting to say, I want to be the best hypnotherapist. That's a thought. But that kind of a thought where you are drowning in sea and the effort to surface, to come out, something like that. Have I conveyed my meaning? The thought is what we have, we are short of words. So I said, creative power of thought in altered state of consciousness. This is the fundamental. There is no possibility in our telling, I want to do this, I want to be like this, I want to be that way, this way. No, that doesn't happen. But, sir, as a pharmacologist, did you study a little bit of biology? Sorry. This is my weakness, I apologize once again. Did you read a little bit of zoology, biology, botany?
Yes, that's my profession.
Yeah, profession. So it's simple. What he knows, metamorphosis. Will you please tell our participants what is metamorphosis?
Because all of them may
not know.
In a biological term, you
know? Yeah, biology.
Well, the most common use of it, of course, is when you see, for example, a little worm turning into a butterfly.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. You got words, or maybe I got the idea out of your mind. A worm obviously doesn't have wings, right? And before it became a worm, maybe it was an egg, a fertilized egg, or whatever it is. But before it became even a worm, it was a fertilized egg. It becomes a worm, and metamorphosis is science. I am not talking fiction. On the authority of our professorial zoologist friend here, that the worm turns into a butterfly. Right? Mm-hmm. Bluff? Am I bluffing?
Yeah.
Thank you. No, because those who are not botanists, not zoologists, would think these two people have aligned to fool us around. We will not fool you. We are not liars. We go to the Google and see the word metamorphosis. This is that metamorphosis is the creative power of thought of that particular worm that I want to be a butterfly. Is that kind of creative power is there? If it is there in a worm, it's there in my head. Fine? That comes out from my consciousness when I am in altered state of consciousness. Ordinary? No. Better still, in Vipassana or in any kind of meditation, better than hypnosis. Why I say better than hypnosis? One friend asked me, why not hypnosis? I said, hypnosis is very good. Very, very good for a limited ambition. I have migraine and I want to cure my migraine. Okay, fair enough. Your natural view. But migraine, to be smoker and non-smoker, change, but is not metamorphosis. From worm to butterfly is metamorphosis. And that kind of change, I'm going to talk a little bit of meditation also, because she asked me so many difficult questions. So I must at least show that I know something about it. I couldn't answer any of them. I divert from a very difficult to understand situation to an ordinary everyday life conversation. You understand the reason. We want to be on the ground all the time. So this creative power of thought, what is it that changes the biological cells of a worm so that from those cells arise the wings of a butterfly? So that is the formative. The same cell which was making the cell of a worm is now making the wings. And that power is there in human consciousness for sure, because it's the basic power in all living forms. The entire living system on this planet is capable of a formative power, and human beings can transcend, transform in having had a thought, then that shall be. Okay. I told this phrase to some of the friends that promises are given. Okay. And they shall be fulfilled. I have done my promise. Okay. So, that promise, once the creature, it gets into each and every cell of the human body, I want to transform, I want to transcend. I don't want to be this creeping worm, I want to fly. So the wings appear. There were no wings. And this formative power, once it comes into action, it's not that it will happen like that. It will happen like magic. Over a period of time, a whole software program in the system gets built up so that it translates into action. And such kind of actions that they lead you to your dreams. For that, again, I take the help of any other zoologist, botanist, hardcore scientist here? No. So I have to take your help, sir. Please tell something about the morphogenetic field. Yeah, this is so important. No, well, please. Then the chair of authority also matters.
Now, you have to define for me a little bit when you say morphogenetic field. I mean, you mean the working of the DNA and the RNA and so on?
That's, Ratni is going to talk, but tell them what is a morphogenetic field.
Well, in my mind, the morphogenetic field is the capacity that exists within the genome
Yeah.
You know, to have this, as you say, formative power. Thank you. How, I wish I had your facility to be brief. It's so precise, I don't have to have even one word. But is in philosophical terms what he said, what I have been talking for 10 minutes, is that the past determines the present. So the book on this morphogenetic field, please don't spend money on it. It's a 30 years old book, and there is so much of zoology in it, pure science. But the title is good. The title says Presence of the Past. And Ulf showed me a book which hypnosis. In hypnosis, past is always present. But presence of the past, there is a seed that in this grows into a tree, and finally that is what is realized. In India we use, in our philosophy, we use words like self-realization. Yes, total silence. But in modern psychology, the American psychologists moderated it to the level of acceptance for all audiences. He called it self-actualization. It's what is a good name, good word to write down and remember. All of us are programmed, if I don't use the word predetermined, because that will conflict with some of the friends' belief. But all of us are programmed to become something through a morphogenetic field. There was some field in Stockholm that has attracted me all the way from India over here. It's not my wish, it was not Ulf's doing, neither did Presto facilitate it. This is my belief. And the belief has the proof in the worm having the wings. Okay. So, 2 minutes now for meditation. Not doing meditation, but how meditation is different from hypnosis. In hypnosis, there is a facilitator. And so there is a motivation to go from here to there. And there is somebody who is going to drive you or fly you past or up to that particular post. That is hypnosis. With hypnosis, what you have put down as your motivation and goal will certainly happen. With meditation, you arrive at a goal that is there in your genes. You don't even know what's my goal. What my genes are doing now, I don't know. But I for sure know that there is a genetic code. And there are so many external factors which otherwise drive me like this. In a meditative state, your self-actualization, what you are totally capable of, and the self-actualization is the word for the Western psychology. I'm not keeping my Indian bias, Indian ethos aside, not using the word self-realization. So self, I am destined to be, I have capacity, is there in my genes to be like this. The best therapist in Sweden. Is that likely to be in your genes?
No.
If you say no, then it won't happen. Okay, sure. But if the lady here says, I believe, okay, you begin and you will be. This was again not what is being told by me. A Western philosopher, 2005 years ago, name him. I already given you the clue. Western philosopher. Socrates, you mean?
Socrates.
His pupil.
Yeah.
You overshooted a few years, but fine. Overshooting is fine.
Plato.
Plato.
Plato
said, idea is the first reality. If it occurs to you that I want to be a butterfly, you will be a butterfly. It never occurred to me to be the best hypnotherapist in Sweden. The genes will keep on sleeping. Thank you. I think I have had my say. Radni has so much to give you hardcore science. Wolf wants stories. Should I finish my story of diabetes now? Okay. He says, come to the ground, not too many high flying. It's a bit personal, but Wolf wants to tell me this, that around my age of 40 plus, when both of us were so very busy that we were working from 6 o'clock to 10 o'clock morning, evening, for our professional work, which involved cesarean sections, running after accident victims and burns patients and all that, I had the first tutorial, I had chest pain on the left side of my chest, and does it go? No. It's not going on. Take a few deep breaths, not going on. My ECG revealed that I had an inverted T wave, which is indicative of ischemia. Ischemia means less blood supply to the heart. And when we did other tests, my blood sugar levels were 350 plus. The normal level should be anywhere between 100 to less than 140. They were 350 and plus. So it was very clear that I should have few more years to live. I'm already at the age of 40, I have got an ischemic heart which is not receiving its enough blood supply. It didn't go to the infarction, means it didn't go to a heart stroke. But diabetes was very wild, and what to do? Today, before I came from Baroda, I checked up my blood sugar level in the morning. It was 72. So I told you, please see that I get good breakfast, because 72 is rather low. You know. How did this happen? In short, I realized that I understand stress. By that time, I had understood stress very well, but not realize that I am under stress. Now I realize I am under very severe stress, so I cut down my work at the expense of cutting down some income. That did me good because I didn't have to look after that money. I realized I was running after something which I don't need. But then the people will come for help. I can't refuse them help, so I started parting with my work. Passed it over to my juniors. I made so many more friends now. This fellow is passing away his work, so we are getting some money, otherwise we were without work. Simple, this thing has continued from that till today. I keep on doing creative things. I don't do monotonous things. Probably I will not come again to Stockholm at all. Why do the same thing? Be creative. That is creativity. But in short, I cut down my diet. We were told in physiology books that time, sir, that an adult needs something like 2800 to 3000 calories. Total is 4. This is the fallacy of modern science. The modern science is so much manipulated. The normal human being, in India, I and Ratni, we both eat between 1200 to 1400 calories a day. I think in Sweden, Wood might be consuming, I have seen him eating, he might, all good things I observe, you know. So don't be scared. I saw he is such a frugal eater, and I don't think he is eating more than 1600 to 1800 calories. Body does, even in Stockholm, we think it's cold country. No, we are at 20 degrees centigrade here most of the time. 1800 calories, I would put a limit. Then the manufacturers of food, protein is so necessary, eat 70 to 100 grams of protein a day. Surely you will end up in various kind of metabolic illnesses, eating this much of amount of proteins, so that the pharmaceuticals and the hospitals may work. We don't need more than 30 grams of protein a day. 20 will do at my age, where I am not regenerating so very much. So 20 to 30 grams of protein. And the story of margarine and butter I told you yesterday, I don't need to repeat. In all, yes, I have limited my diet to about 1200 to 1400 calories. I was doing exercises 20 to 30 minutes a day. That was all I did, and that was not enough. That's why my legs are not working well. I should have done more. But the crucial input came. I stopped the work for a while, went to an ashram for, without knowing vipassana, we did vipassana. Vipassana is not, the word is from Pali language, which is a branch of Sanskrit, but it means only a spatial reflection. Ordinarily we all see, but let's see in a special way what Presto might call mindfulness, or those people who are psychologists here would call a dialectical behavior therapy. That's all. Dialectical behavior therapy is verbatim copied from Vipassana. But just see, why should I have diabetes? So I said, yes, my father had, but my father had very little. So probably my genes are there, and my father got it at the age of 60. I'm having that kind of dialectical thinking. And we realized that the stressful situation which puts so much of agility to the mind, this, that, is the generative ground for my diabetes, for most illnesses. Meditation brings you to the restful, quiet, peaceful state. Okay. So much that if you miss a train, never worry, another one is going to come. If you lose a book to a friend, be sure when you lend it, that is not going to return. And in case he gives it back, it will be torn, be sure that if you loan money to a friend, is 100% right off. So you are happy when he is a gentleman and gives it back. And finally, if we lose our partner, she is going to stay with me forever. But if we lose our partner, a loved friend, wife, husband, soulmate, never mind. That was the way it was destined. I don't have any free will. So I am not culpable, responsible for it. This is my stress relief formula for control of not only my diabetes, but thereafter I never had chest pain. And before coming to the West, I had to undergo a physical examination. My cardiologist said, where is that T wave gone? In your last ECG I did, there was that inverted T wave. I said, forget about it, never was. So health is something which I did nothing except to control my stress. And all of us are capable of doing it. Thank you. What do we do now?
But you did mention that you meditated quite a lot.
I am a regular meditator.
Yes.
And I am familiar with Vipassana. But we discussed Vipassana before coming here. Before that, I had gone through several other ways of meditating. And finally, I have evolved my own method of meditation. It's not necessary to stick to a particular way or to a particular guru. If I learned, when I am on a personal note, there was a guru, Maharshi Mahesh Yogi. He was a physicist to begin with. And so he was a scientist. And he put meditation in my paradigm of being a scientist. And his method was transcendental meditation. It became a trademark also and generated enormous amount of wealth for the guru to settle down and die 2 years back in Holland. But I am very respectfully acknowledging my gratitude to him because he was the one who told me meditation will work for you because I believe science is God. And this fellow is talking science, so let me follow the scientific way. Today I don't do the TM way. I have my own methods. I went through several gurus and several methodology. That's not important. But meditation by whatever name, a rose by whatever name, will taste the same. Complete the last word. I thought you people were literary giants also. Don't you read Shakespeare? This was said by Shakespeare. A rose by any name will smell the same sweet. Shakespeare.
Do you have any basic rules for the meditation? I mean, even if you have find your own way, could you recommend for us 2 times a day, 20 minutes?
Yeah, I would say no. I'm very willing on this, provided rule permits. Because stop me, I will answer this question, but stop me in answering this question also. There is so much we want to give, and so much you people have asked. So, what you will discover your own method. You are already a hypnotherapist. From that you arrive at self-hypnosis. In self-hypnosis, Radhni probably didn't take you to creative visualization yesterday.
Partly I took today.
She can give you a program for self-hypnosis today. You can then modify that program according to your own belief, your own culture, your own personal sensibilities. Abdul is here, right?
He's here, yeah.
You change the chair. So, see, Abdul is a Muslim by name, but he is an evolved, that kind of an evolved citizen of Sweden, that all religions are good and equal. I am a Hindu by birth. So, I today, when I go to a mosque and they say, why are you here? I tell them, I am a Muslim. Because I want to enter the mosque. Then, oh, come. So, but our cultural bias does influence us. This is Ganpati, as we call it. But he is the one who guards all evils away and produces the Hindu mythological and my belief, produces all that is good. So, in the morning, I teach my grandchildren, think of Ganpati before you go to the school. This is the Hindu idol. And each part of this figure has a significance. I don't go into why there are long ears and why it's a half animal and half elephant and all that. But just pass on. This is Buddha doing vipassana. So if she might, while doing vipassana, she may begin with a Buddha. Though Buddha was not born in Sweden and was never here, Buddha is everywhere. Because Buddha is one who is enlightened. I want to enlighten myself. If that is your goal, I want to enlighten myself, I want to become a Buddha, have Buddha.